I see in my dreams the high hills of Antrim, her glens and her streams, in sunlight or shadow, in weal and in woe. The sweet vision haunts me wherever I go. Down the wild sleeve, nanay, the lammas winds roar. Their pealings are echoed round rocky park moor. Glenarith is troubled, my heart's full of woe, for love unrequited and hindered desire. Ah, the blue hills of Antrim I see in my dreams, the high hills of Antrim, her glens and her streams, in sunlight or shadow, in weal and in woe. That sweet vision haunts me wherever I go. As fleet as the changes on mountain and dale, so fleet are my moods and so many their tale. I sigh with the shadows, I laugh with the shine. When there's joy in these glens' heart, sure there's gladness in mine.
ROVERS show in Northern Ireland tonight. Isn't it great fun? They'll be back in a minute.
Young Molly was handsome and pretty. I put on me new Sunday coat. Away I did go for to court her, myself and me small ruin coat. I hadn't gone more than 4 furlongs, not more than 10 minutes afloat, when a big wave came up and capsized us, myself and me small rowing boat.
Come up the stairs, come up the stairs, Molly, O. Come up the stairs, bring something to warm me old bones.
Up comes a great big sea serpent, he was 40 long feet, an hour and more. He'd one look at my starting features, and they offered to take me ashore.
Now where were you going in such weather?
I was going courting Molly, says I.
Sure there's no young ones left on the island, so how's a young man to get by?
Come up the stairs, come up the stairs, Molly, oh. Come up the stairs, bring something to warm me old bones.
Why don't you and Molly get married, and then you can both stay at home, where it's better to suffer in marriage than catching your death in the cold.
Well, tonight I will ask her to marry, I'm hoping that she will agree. Sure I'd rather be poor and be married than risking me life on the sea.
Come up the stairs, come up the stairs, Molly, oh. Come up the stairs,
so yourself can be warm and me both.
Stand where the peaks meet the sky and the locks meet the sea, where the rivers run clear and the bracken is golden in the sun. Ah, but cares of tomorrow can wait till this day is done. Come by the hills to the land where legend remains, where stories of old fill the heart and may yet come again. For past has been lost and the future has yet to be won. Ah, but cares of tomorrow can wait till this day is done.
Many hundreds of years ago, a Viking ship approached the waters off this beautiful province of Ulster, and the chief of the Vikings told his crew that whoever should put his hand on the land first would become lord of that land. Two young Vikings volunteered for the job and plunged into the icy waters. One of them was a man called Neil. As he approached the land, he noticed that he wasn't going to win. So he came up with a very good plan. He drew his sword and cut off his right hand and flung it onto the land. Thus, he was the first to lay hand on the province of Ulster. Neil went on to be Lord of Ulster, and his sons and his descendants have been the Lords of Ulster ever since, the O'Neills. They have been involved in the politics and the history and in the general well-being of Ulster. Their seat was here at Sheehan Castle for many, many years, and it's here at the beautiful Sheehan Castle that we would like to present to you the beautiful Seven Towers dancers from Ballymena, County Antrim, doing the Ring of Kerry.
Blackened the land, and I look now for of something that I may never find. It's a problem that's now close at hand. There's a fever that's raging and the winds have died away, and their journey can no longer be. Though the plague is a shadow that lingers night and day, warmer thoughts on green valleys I see. Fare thee well, green valleys, God keep you the same. If and only my mind you'll be. I'm sailing dark waters to far America. Nevermore my green valleys to see.
You told me that the last time we were here, you were telling me a wee bit about the pub, and we didn't really tell anybody about it, but was it your great-grandfather had this?
No, my grandfather, John MacDonald, and then my father, he was a veterinary surgeon.
And you ran a pub on the side?
Then, yes, yeah.
And you worked in here?
Myself.
What age were you when you first started working in here?
I was, 18 about, when 18. I started working in the bar. I left the convent, the Cross and Passion Convent.
You came from a convent to work in a pub?
Yeah. Why not?
I bet you could write a good book. If I got a tape recorder.
I don't know about writing books. I wouldn't be much good at that.
What about if I got a tape recorder and sit down with you for a few hours? If you could tell me some stories about this pub, I'll bet you.
I could. The old people that came in were all very nice people.
Well, you know something, Mary? In our travels, as we go around, the people you meet in this town are all very nice in Ballycastle. But I was telling you, as we travel around the world, and since we were here the last time doing a wee bit of filming, we've spread the gospel of Mary MacDonald's pub all around the world, so I'm telling you, anybody that wants to come down to Ballycastle for a nice afternoon...
Just imagine that,
Mary. Quiet pint, Mary MacDonald's is the place to come. It's a lovely old pub. Mary, you know, I've got a smashing idea.
What?
If you would nip up the bar there and pour these thirsty boys a couple of pints...
Oh, that's a smashing idea.
Perhaps we might sing you a song.
Yeah, well, I hope you do.
We will. Right. We'll liven the place up.
I would love that.
Okay. Mary, pour us a couple of pints, we'll sing Mickey Dolan's Whiskey.
I'll tell you all about a man who lives out in the sea, in a lighthouse on an island all alone in fancy free. He brews the finest whiskey, Mickey Dolan is his name. And when the pubs are closed and Mickey's boat is on the main. Drink up your porter, boy, the whiskey's coming in. It will warm up your innards, man, you're looking very thin. For later on this evening, the boat is coming again. With Mickey Dolan's whiskey in a bucket made of tin.
There's farmers and there's millers and there's them that fish the sea. There's men who sew the cloth for us, they're useful, you'll agree. But the man we love the best that is still out in the sea, his whiskey is as sweet as the honey from the bee.
Sing it. Drink up your porter, boy, the whiskey's coming in. It will warm up your innards, man, you're looking very thin. Where later on this evening the boat is coming in, with Mickey Dolan's whiskey in the bucket made of tin.
His fame is spread far and wide, they come from near and far, to smuggle Mickey's whiskey by the crate and by the jar. Now the Germans and the Frenchies have given up their wine, and Mickey Dolan and the still are working overtime.
Drink up your porter, boy, the whiskey's coming in. It will warm up your innards, man, you're looking very thin. Where later on this evening the boat is coming in, with Mickey Dolan's whiskey in a bucket made of tin.
You got the pints ready, Mary? Thank you, Mary, very much. Ladies and gentlemen, from Mary MacDonald's pub in Ballycastle in the North Antrim coast, we bid you good night and thank you very much for watching, and we hope you've enjoyed yourself as much as we have in the pub here tonight. God bless me. You'll be half an hour in heaven before the devil knows you're dead.
I've traveled all over this world, and now to another.